Learning rate tuning can be very strange. For example, you might think that using a higher learning rate means that you learn more or that you learn faster. That's just not true. In fact, you can often take a model, lower the learning rate, and get to a better model faster. It gets even worse. You might be tempted to look at the curve that shows the loss over time to see how quickly you learn. Here, the higher learning rate starts faster, but then it plateaus, when the lower learning rate keeps on going and gets better. It is a very familiar picture for anyone who's trained neural networks. Never trust how quickly you learn. It has often little to do with how well you train. This is where SGD gets its reputation for being black magic. You have many, many hyperparameters that you could play with. Initialization parameters, learning rate parameters, decay, momentum, and you have to get them right. In practice, it's not that bad. But if you have to remember just one thing, is that when things don't work, always try to lower your learning rate first. There are lots of good solutions for small models, but sadly, none that's completely satisfactory so far for the very large models that we really care about. I'll mention one approach called Adagrad that makes things a little bit easier. Adagrad is a modification of SGD, which implicitly does momentum and learning rate decay for you. Using Adagrad often makes learning less sensitive to hyperparameters, but it often tends to be a little worse than precisely tuned SGD with momentum. It's still a very good option, though, if you're just trying to get things to work. So let's recap. We have this very simple linear model, which emits probabilities, which we can use to classify things. We now know how to optimize its parameters on lots and lots of data using SGD and its variance. It's still a linear, shallow model, though. But now we have all the tools that we need. It's time to go deeper.